Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding big questions for our generation written by Barkha Deva. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies, mains examination paper 2 plus paper 3 plus paper 1. Plus this is also very important for public administration, political science, sociology and anthropology optional students. Plus, this is also very important from essay point of view. Now, what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how the government, they end up without going into the nitty-gritties of the requirement of the laws, are hell-bent on bringing about the amendments in them. This editorial is also about how we need to peep very deep into the laws in order to look out for the requirement for which the alteration should be done in the laws. Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all, we need to understand what is the true meaning of democracy. Now, the democracy means participation. Democracy means the people are having the right to protect their own rights, to protect their interests. Now, anybody who is having a common sense knows about their own welfare, knows about what they want from the society. Now, placing a qualification for fighting the elections is actually doing away with the provision of democracy, is actually thwarting the democracy, is actually dissuading the democracy, is actually trampling the democracy. Now, if you look at Aristotle and Plato, though they were against democracy, they were against the democracy when the people are not educated. But as far as India is concerned, we have adopted the system of democracy and we had done away with the myopic, with the squenched electorates that were prevalent during the British days. We have provided this universal adult suffrage to everybody. We have made this thing universal. Anybody who is above 18 has a right to vote. Anybody who is above 18 can think about the welfare of the society irrespective of whether he or she is educated or not. Now, kind of the education system we are having, it cannot assure the mental development of a person. The education system currently that we are possessing, it is more on the ratification. It has got less to do with the development of the inner qualities of a person. So the legislation that has been passed in Haryana that anybody who wants to fight for the Panchayati Raj elections should have a qualification, that is minimum of senior secondary, that he or she must have passed plus two examination. Now, this author wants that this kind of amendment is actually a retrograde step. Till the time we are not having a kind of education system which can really enrich the mental level of the people. Now, the second kind of amendment that the government is mulling to introduce is with respect to the child labor. Now, if you really want to end child labor, it should be completely abolished. There should not be any kind of a leeway. There should not be any kind of an excuse which could be manipulated, which could be maneuvered by the people, by the corporate sector, by the parents to wee their children or to wee the child to get employed, because this will defeat the purpose of the bill to abolish the child labor. Now the third law that this writer has talked about is with respect to doing away with the no detention policy. Now what is no detention policy? No detention policy is a part of the right to education that has been introduced by the previous government. Now as per the no detention policy, any student will not be made to stay in the same class. Rather, the progress would be assured. Means a student will not be tested on the basis of a question paper for whether he or she should be alleviated to the next class or not. Alleviation is assured in the kind of education system currently we are having. And this kind of a system is known as no detention policy. Means that the schools will not be detaining the students in their classes. Rather, they will be allowing the students to pass. Now this kind of system is criticized because in no detention policy, you cannot judge a student. You cannot examine a student on the basis of the abilities that he or she is gaining or he or she is imbibing. Now, another law that this writer has talked about is about the Juvenile Justice Act, of about lowering the age. Now there is a kind of a lot of hullabaloo about reducing the age from 18 to 16. But if you look at the international practices, if you do a comparative studies with European countries or with the Southeast Asian countries, or even with that case of Middle East countries, the psychologists suggests that the age should not be reduced, because till the time one is not 18, there is a lesser mental development. And how a person acts in the age below 18 is more on the basis of a peer pressure. So there needs to dichotomize between the juvenile and between an adult. You cannot erase this boundary between a juvenile and an adult. You cannot erase a boundary between a child and a man. You need to create this boundary. This boundary is existent. We differentiate between a child, a man, and an old man. There is a kind of differentiation. There is a kind of differentiation in their mental prowess, in their mental progress. Now, as per writer, we really need to think over the nitty-gritties of the kind of the alteration that the government is about to bring in these laws. And these four areas, they are a potent area for the next year's mains examination. You will definitely be getting one question out of these four legislations. The more expectant being the child labor or the juvenile thing. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And out of all these decode classes that I have done in last 2 years, we have got about 12 questions from 20 in General Studies Mains Examination Paper 2. So these classes are very important if you want to crack civil services examination. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainy Key. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video, and do participate in the answer writing program, because that is something that will assure your selection in the civil services examination. Without answer writing classes, without decode classes, and without the package we are offering, it would be bit difficult, not impossible, bit difficult. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.